So what's going on with you guys?
Well, I want to know kind of what the new wrinkle for
Krieger?
Krieger is going to be this year.
Krieger again?
Yeah.
There's one wrinkle.
We're no longer
a bird. Well, no, we're not human. We're a synthetic human this time. Now he's a robot as opposed to a clone. Like in the Aliens franchise, he's a synthetic human with milk blood. So he's a robot. Catches a lot of hell for it.
Awesome.
Because he's the one on board.
So does Robot Krieger like it in space since he's built for that?
Yeah. There's a lot of sort of like, kind of like Spock, where there's just sort of a cold logic side to him, except that, you know, they pick on him a lot. So he does, and he has emotions. Unlike Spock, I guess. Krieger gets sad. But yeah, he digs space.
Krieger's had a lot of interesting revelations and transformations.
Yeah,
over
big
the,
changes over the year.
Has there any that have stuck out as a favorite of yours, including this
other
year's?
Than Crackers?
Yeah.
Because of Crackers, above all. I love Crackers. Yeah. And I feel so bad saying it.
But
I love that bird. my favorite Krieger. I love the San Marcos season, whatever season that is when we go to San Marcos. When we're drug dealers, the drug dealer season. Because he runs into the other clones. And so it opens up the world of Krieger. Like, just, it asks so many questions of like, man, how many of these guys are running around? And who is Krieger Prime? There's got to be one at the top somewhere. I don't think it's our Krieger. We still haven't even answered which Krieger we have from that season.
Is there a dip into, you know, kind of coming closer to that revelation in this season?
In this season? No, because we're in outer space and I'm a robot. But so who knows? Who knows what will happen in the future? Not this guy.
Has it been a challenge to reinvent the show every year?
For us, it's a blast, you know, it's because it's the same characters, but we get to do completely different things every year and put different little spins on everything. I know the fans are like freaking out about it every time we do one of these. Well, some of the grumpier ones. I shouldn't say the fans, because our fans are amazing.
Yeah.
But some of your grumpier types get really bent out of shape, as though this cartoon, these people are real, you know what I mean? And it's like, just relax and enjoy the ride, guys. So to sort of reinvent every year, for us, it's amazing. It's so much fun. I think the show could go on forever if we just kept doing that. Because it's, you know, at the core, it's about how these characters deal with one another. It's this sort of dysfunctional family in the middle of something that, you know, they're going to bicker their way through and hopefully succeed.
Is it hard to work yourself up to those loud yelling, bickering moments?
I'm very loud as just a human being. So it's tougher to sort of like tone things down for me. They're just like, hey, don't be so loud in this one.
I feel that you might be a fan of the sci-fi genre.
Oh, yeah. Huge fan.
So is there a particular film that you love seeing kind of parodied in this season?
Hold on, I'm being felt up. This is very exciting. A ghost. I've just been...
been fondled by a ghost.
Gross. It's my executive producer. Now I take it all back. Wait, what?
That's an HR scenario there.
Yeah. I think I just... Disney. Dear Disney. Look what just happened. Anyway.
But...
As a fan of sci-fi.
Is there a space film that's kind of parodied in this season that you're really looking forward to?
I've seen the first episode already, so I don't know from this point on how things are look, but sort of the look of the show, we really are paying a lot of homage to the Aliens franchise, and it's one of my favorite franchises because it's sci-fi horror, which are, you know, two of my biggest happy places. So I love that we, and you know, it's the clunky sort of 70s version of what the future will be, right? Clackety keyboards and weird things that like don't really make, like, oh man, we've far surpassed a lot of the tech that's on the ship already, you know
Space
what I mean?
Hoover.
So yeah, getting back to that sort of like, this is what people thought the future would be, is a lot of fun.
Cool.
And seeing little blips of that throughout the season, it's great.